All right, everybody. So this is Shawn Michaels coming out here. I got off work. I'm finishing up Raw. I pretty much heard that. I'm pretty sure he gets the punt. I'm pretty sure I got spoiled on it, but Shawn Michaels coming out here with his NXT hat. Marina and Duke were in Underground, so they're gonna be on Raw now? All right, vintage Shawn pose. Okay, so. The Showstopper. So they're building up, so Drew McIntyre feels like he's letting everybody down, he said. But Shawn is like, no. Okay, here we go. What are we looking at? Okay. Orton is so jacked. Because after 31 days of being intense. I got my Ric Flair. Got my Ric Flair shirt on. Woo! I woke up and all I wanted to do. Such a good promo. Was to tell the people who I hadn't told that I love them. And to make sure everybody that I loved knew all I felt, because you have to be this close to where I was to know what that feeling is.
Such a deep promo.
I'm not trying to take anything from you.
Sorry.
I'm just walking down that alley and having a good time. All I am right now, I'm Charlotte's dad and want to be part of Randy Orton's life. You know, last week with tears rolling down my face,
I mean, it was very emotional.
Else. As Ric Flair reminded us of the worst 31 days of his life, and for many of us, the worst 31 days of our lives too, as he sat on his deathbed and wanting to do nothing but tell people that mean the most to him how much he loved him.
Is he getting choked up?
And
John.
You have to understand Ric Flair.
He retired him.
But Ric, well, more than anybody, loved
WWE.
Performing inside this ring for the WWE Universe. And if it wasn't for guys like Ric Flair, I can assure you there would be no Shawn Michaels. There would be no Triple H, no Batista, no Edge, no Christian. No Big Show, and certainly no Drew McIntyre.
True.
And of course, the one guy, that's also on that list is you, Randy Orton.
Ooh, Randy, okay, here
we
go.
But you, unlike the rest of us, you don't have the same gratitude and appreciation for Ric Flair that the rest of us do. Even though you had him mentoring you for years, you had the greatest wrestler ever.
Ooh.
Mentoring you on a daily basis.
Shawn.
Randy Orton feels like he was owed that. He deserved that.
Ric Flair is great.
Randy, I don't know how it's going to happen, but I can assure you it is going to happen. At SummerSlam, I don't know if you're going to meet your justice at the end of a sweet chin music.
Special guest referee?
Or if you meet it from a claymore at the hands of Drew McIntyre, but I can assure you.
Is he going to be the ref?
At SummerSlam, you will see it coming.
Oh, okay.
Words.
Viper's going to come out. Oh, RKO. Okay. He did it. Right into the punt. Here comes McIntyre. That was the fastest RKO into the punt that I've ever seen. Well, am I McIntyre? Oh, wow. Whoa, Sean without his hat on. HBK, he's getting up though. Oh, Orton came back. McIntyre's battling. Okay, he's out of the ring. Are we gonna have a new champ? What's gonna happen? Oh my gosh. I think we're gonna have a new champion, guys. Do you think so? Ooh. McIntyre is taking care of business. Taking care of business. Okay, but Sean is like getting up though. He kind of by himself. I'm trying to remember all the punts and I feel like this Sean is the one that's. RKO, okay. Wow. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe McIntyre retains. Get Randy Snakes! Like a snake coming out of the ring here. Look at this. Are they going to do that shot they did last week? Oh, it went out. Okay, so I felt like this was a good segment. I kind of figured that Sean would get something, but he got the punt. He got the RKO and the punt so fast, and then Drew McIntyre came out. But then Sean's getting to his feet. I'm trying to remember everybody who got punt. I felt like Sean got up fairly quickly. I don't know. Well, I hopefully everybody had a good night. I just finished Raw. It's pretty late, but have a great night. And thanks for checking out my channel, my stream. Aaron, this isn't my stream. This is a reaction. All right, good night. SummerSlam, take over this weekend. Yes.